Graduates, just this once, here in this hall, without all the chaos outside, with your family, your friends, your tutors, and your mentors. It's all about you. I am totally engaged with what you've been studying and where you are heading. That's why I wanted to be here this evening. As you prepare for your careers in marketing, advertising, communication, and most exciting of all, journalism, which I would say because I'm a journalist. It's worth remembering that it's going to be your job, your duty even, to inform, entertain, and hopefully educate the millions of people, the consumers rather, as the marketeers in the room would have us know, the millions of people who are going to encounter your work over the coming years. And you probably gathered already, it is not an easy job. I've been a journalist for almost 30 years at a senior level, first in newspapers, now in television. And I can assure you, it has never been harder. In news media, you're responsible for making, I'm generalizing, but you're responsible for making complicated issues simple enough for ordinary people to understand. The public, who of course are going to be your audience, the people that pay your wages, for the marketeers, of course, the consumers, forgive me again. They're going to be looking to you for guidance, and it's soon going to be your job to offer it to the world. What are you going to say? There's a question for the rest of it. Who are you going to be working for? Le Monde, the Huffington Post, a nice new digital publication, the Daily Mail, or maybe the Daily Mail's online sister publication, the Mail Online, which is fabulously successful, and which, whilst I was cobbling together these words on Monday afternoon, managed to insert a photo of Khloe Kardashian. For anyone over 14, she's a member of the Kardashian family. Khloe Kardashian in a teeny weeny bikini under the headline, Khloe strips down as she prepares for sexy photo shoot. And that photo was placed immediately below a picture of Eagles of Death Metal fans at the Bataclan. Headline, minutes from slaughter. What do you put in, what do you leave out? I feel this too, but I would say the biggest revolution in journalism since I started my career bashing away on an old typewriter, like that. I really am that old, truly. It's the Botox. I think the biggest revolution in journalism since I have been alive has been the advent of citizen journalism and the arrival of the smartphone, right? I think the two are inextricably linked. Citizen journalists were the first to tell us of the Arab Spring, Tunisia, Egypt, Syria, lest we forget, albeit not for very long. And while it was impossible to verify each individual source, and verifying sources is the name of the journalistic game we used to be, the collective impression that all those reports gave was one of truth. And truth is not something I detect in newspaper stories or television stories very often these days. I want you to go out there and do the very best media work you can do. This is a wide open playing field. You can do it in radio, television, advertising, marketing if you have to, animation, the internet, whatever, wherever you like. Just go out there and do it. I've heard your teachers, your lecturers, I've spoken to them. I know that they have given you a fantastic training. Just go out there and do it. Thank you.